Before watching the video, don't forget to subscribe the channel and enable bell notification to never miss an update from us.
Hello friends, welcome to Entry. I, Deepani Bhardwaj, welcome to all again. And today we are going to discuss how to start bank's preparation in 2021. So we'll be discussing regarding that. Apart from that, we'll also understand that almost all bank syllabus is same. So your single lecture is going to help you out in all your bank exams. Fine. So let's start with our topic. So how to start bank preparation 2021. So bank jobs are always considered to be one of the best jobs in India, isn't it? And you are aware of that lakhs of students are applying for this job every year, and many of them succeed and some of them fail to do so. But why do they fail? So we are going to discuss on that also. So being a high profile job, getting into this is a way tougher than you expect. Now, this is not for demoralizing you, but to tell you that if you take proper steps, then you can easily crack it. Fine. So every year lakhs of aspirants apply for the various bank jobs and only a few thousand are able to make into the final list. So the selection of candidates does not depend on the fact that they went to the well-reputed coaching centers or were blessed with such intelligence. No, it's not like that. The one who gets selected in the bank entrance examination is not always the one who has taken study or has joined a top coaching institute and given a large amount of fees there. No, it's not like that. Because as you know that many of the students are there who just crack the examination and tell that we never visited any of the coaching centers. We just prepared ourselves and used online means to study. Fine. Now, how to prepare? If we talk about the prelim section first, then the prelim section of any of the banking examination is always same. Whereas, almost same. But whereas if we talk about mains examination, then it varies from examination to examination. That is from different banks or the conducting bodies to another. Now, if we talk about the prelims, then see, almost all the banks are having this for the prelims. That is, there are three sections, namely the reasoning ability, quantitative ability, English language. But if we talk about especially about RRBs, then here one part is not there, that is English. Fine. Now we are talking almost for almost every bank, so we'll take it into the considerance and let's understand there would be 35 questions from reasoning part, 35 from quant and 30 from English language, and the marks are accordingly same. That is 35 marks for reasoning, 35 for quant and 35 for English. So we know that 100 questions of 100 marks are going to come there, and the total time duration that is given is of 1 hour, or we can say it's of 60 minutes. So this was what? This was for prelims. Now, if we talk about the mains part, then there is no specific examination pattern for the bank's mains examination, as different banking examination are having different types of paper. So if we talk in an average or on an average, then what all things are there? There will be five sections, that is reasoning, quant, general awareness, computer awareness and English language. And as you know that most of the banking examination conducting bodies have merged this computer awareness with the reasoning ability part. Fine. But RRB still takes separate section for the computer. So knowing the examination pattern is not only the key for your preparation plan. You require more than that. Fine. So you must be aware of the syllabus of the examination. That is first and foremost thing. Almost all banking examinations mostly follow the same syllabus, but you must be updated with the topics that are included in the examination. Fine. So what will happen? This is going to help you out in the preparation, and there will be a blueprint of your preparation plan. Because once blueprint is there, you are able to understand how you are going to study and what is going to make you succeed in the examination. Now, once you have fair knowledge of the examination pattern and syllabus of the examination you are preparing for, it's the time for you to swing into the action and start your preparation, because each and every minute is important now. And You must only take rest once your mission is accomplished. And your mission is what? To get into the banking. Fine. So this is the point where you should start understand. You should understand how to prepare for the bank examination. Main thing, without coaching, and this is also going to help you out, because this will save your time for going for the offline classes. Fine. Now, if we talk about all those important points, then the first important point or the first step for the examination prepare would be proper planning. See, proper planning is important for the examination. If proper planning is not there, then not only for the examination, in daily life also, if you're not planning in the proper way, then that particular task may not be achieved well, isn't it? So first of all, get to know about the bank's examination syllabus. It is the first and important thing. Apart from that, you must also be aware about the pattern. Fine. So this is because every bank examination consists of many things, like bank examination syllabus, preparation time, sectional cutoffs, like many things are there. So you must be aware for that. Candidates must gear up their preparation and be aware of different topics from the syllabus. The bank examination paper may have questions from any particular section or topic of the syllabus. So syllabus is very important. Apart from that, pattern is also important. So here, candidates should be well prepared to attempt a variety of bank examination questions. The key to excelling in the bank examination is to practice and practice. And you have already listened that practice is making you perfect, or practice is going to make you perfect. So practice always makes you perfect. The second and important point is make a proper study timetable for the study, because it's already the year's starting. So there must be a well-planned timetable so that you can easily crack the examination. So aspirants who are willing to prepare at home must and should have a proper timetable regarding their self-study. They must be able to manage their times for the topics, and they must be covered, because many times it happens that we think that this part is quite tough, so we'll take it later on. No, when you are studying, please cover it up, because at the last moment only revision is needed, and you have to make the notes, proper notes for that, so that at the last moment you can just go through those notes. Fine. Now, candidates should have good knowledge of the banking examination syllabus, which I have already told you many times, and they should be thorough with each and every topic and section, as the bank examination paper is likely to include different types of questions into it. So first of all, candidates need to know where they are lagging, and then they need to work on the topics so that there would be no problem meeting the sectional cutoffs. Since sectional cutoffs are there, you must be able to crack each and every section apart from overall merit list as well. Fine. So besides, candidates also need to focus on how much time they need to solve a particular question. And this can be achieved in a way that is, you must give online examination right from today itself. And how can you do that? You can go on our entry application and start giving tests so that you will be aware how much time you are taking. Fine. There are different rank booster quiz. Please go through that. Third thing, complete the syllabus topic wise. This is the important thing, because if you are studying in such a way that you don't even know from which topic the question is coming, then there is going to be a big problem. You must be aware from what topics, how many number of questions will come, what type of questions will come, and that can be achieved only when you are studying topic wise. So remembering the question is difficult, but if you study topic wise, then it will be easy to complete all the topics, and it would be easy to cover up whole syllabus easily. And at the time of examination, you can quickly solve the questions. If we talk about the fourth point, then what is the fourth point? Fourth point is that learn through the online resources. As I've already told you that if you go to the offline coaching centers, it will take you a lot of time. Fine. So candidates who are willing to prepare for the bank examinations at home, the best way to learn is by referring to various competitive bank examination books. But remember that the best available material will be there on the online means, because those materials are regularly updated. Fine. So if possible, go with the online resources. Besides, candidates need to update themselves regularly, because most of the questions in the bank examination are asked from the general knowledge part. So reading daily newspaper can improve, and even they will be helpful for you to increase your verbal skills, and apart from verbal skills, your general awareness section is going to improve as well. So see, general awareness is going to come in the mains examination, that's for sure. Apart from that, if your reading skills are good, then in English section also you will be able to solve many of the questions. So please read newspapers regularly. If possible, English newspapers and good English news channel would be helpful to you, fruitful to you. Candidates should try and make use of online resources by downloading the relevant bank examination books or study material, and practice more and more mock papers and previous year papers. Fine, for the better preparation. And the best resource, I can tell you, you can go on our entry application and take each and everything from there. Now, this thing I have already told you, you have to practice a lot, keep on practicing so that you can get selected in the first attempt itself. After completing the bank examination syllabus, candidates need to practice more and refer to online resources, as these are most useful and updated contents. See, updated contents are going to come only in the online means. If you are taking the books which were printed 2 or 3 years before, they are not going to help you, because constantly each and every pattern questions are changing. So you must be aware of that. Fine. So candidates should track their time and accuracy. This is important. Time and accuracy will be how can you get into the time and accuracy part? See, you will be able to track your time and accuracy only when you will be giving online examination, because in the at the center also, examination center also, you will be sitting on the system. So why don't you keep on practicing from today itself? So please keep track of your time and accuracy while solving your problems. It is for the candidates to judge how much time they are devoting to each question and not get wedded to a particular question, and maintain a close check on the proper time duration for each question. It's not like that a single question is taking 15 minutes for you and you are going and solving in that, and because of that particular question, many of the questions you are going to leave behind. So please try to understand what all questions are to be left, what all questions are to be attempted, and that is going to come only by practicing and nothing else. Fine. Then comes your revision part. Making short notes of the bank examination syllabus can prove beneficial for the candidates during last minute revision. It is important to note that revision is the only thing that is needed to crack a bank examination when candidates are done with the complete bank examination syllabus. If a candidate is not good at any particular topic, then he or she needs to find out where the problem lies and start working on the topic. So this is going to come only by revision part. Fine. You have to just keep on constantly practicing, and while practicing, keep in mind that the notes which you have made are going to help you out further. So please make notes in such a way that you are able to read it in the proper way later on. Fine. The short notes are most important at the time of examination, as it becomes easier to revise in the last minute. Fine. So please make proper notes of it, take proper revision, and keep on practicing. And if I conclude each and everything, then what you must do? You must first have a look on the syllabus, get into the pattern part, because knowing the pattern is of utmost importance. Then take each and every topic, then complete the syllabus, because topic wise completion of the syllabus is the best way in which you can crack the examination. Keep on practicing, make proper notes, and please revise it properly. And yes, do not forget to give regular mock tests and other tests, because that test or those tests are going to increase your rank and it will act as a rank booster. It is very, very important. Fine. And if I say what is going to help you in the general awareness and current affairs, then candidates who are willing to take examinations in 2021 must have the habit of reading the newspapers, magazines about politics, Indian economy, etc., to have good knowledge of the current affairs and day-to-day happenings, because it is going to help you out in the general awareness section, as I have already told you. Apart from that, reading good newspapers, good news channels, listening to the good news channels is going to increase your vocab part, and you will be able to easily crack English section as well. Fine. So this was all about how to prepare for the banking examination in 2021. In case you have any doubt, comment section is available for you. Please do comment on it. like it, share as much as possible, and yes, do not forget to subscribe our channel. So thanking you for watching this video. Thanks a lot.